Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to split and join paths to make custom shapes in Photoshop. Before we have a look at how we can split and join paths in Photoshop, let's just see one of the things that we can do with split paths. I have a custom shape here. This is the original Photoshop custom shape and it's in your collection so you can use it anytime. When I go to fill that shape with a fill color, it fills really nicely, but sometimes I mightn't want lines that thick. And if I go ahead and then try and stroke it with a brush, let's just select it again, click the brush tool, and when I stroke it with a brush, even quite a narrow brush, let's see that, and I'll stroke it with a brush, and you can see that I get double lines. Now, if I wanted that sort of line effect but without the edges on it, I can do that in Photoshop if I first create a more open path. Now, these paths don't have the end on them. While the fill option gives me something very different, when I go to stroke it with a brush, let's just select our brush here, you can see that I get lines that perhaps I want in this certain situation. So we're going to see how we can split this particular shape and just split it apart so that we get separate lines instead of a shape that fills that way. In another situation, this is something else you might want to do. This is a path, and again, it will fill really nicely, but if I go to, let's just undo it, if I go to brush it, I get that sort of brush effect. Now, if I wanted a brushed path that looks like this, then I'll need to split it in parts, and again, that's what I'm going to show you how to do. So let's just tuck this image away for now. Let's go and get a brand new image. And let's draw these shapes. So the first one I want to do, these are both from Photoshop's own collection so that you can go and try this yourself. The first one I'm going to use is this wave shape. Now, when I draw the wave shape into Photoshop and select it using the Path Selection tool, you can see these are the nodes in the shape. Now, the trick is to delete the nodes that you don't want. The problem is as soon as we go into one of these nodes, let's just go to the direct selection tool here, as soon as I try to delete this one, you can see I lose part of my path, and that's really not what I want to happen. So the solution is to go in here with this tool, which is the Add Anchor Point tool, and just click to add some extra anchors. These anchors are all now added and they're selected. You can see their little black marks there. So now if I press the delete key, I'm going to delete the anchors that I created, but watch what's happened. We've actually split the path. So we've been able to split the path by adding anchors and then just deleting them. And that split the path into six individual lines instead of two thick ones. Now let's look and see what happens when we go and stroke it with a brush. Now we get those thin lines that are not joined together. Let's have a look at the spiral, because that's a slightly different situation in that Photoshop already has given us the points for this spiral that we can use to undo it. So I'm just going to select the spiral. It's here. So I'm clicking it to select it, and I'm just going to draw it into my document holding the shift key to constrain it to its proportions. Now let's go and have a look at the spiral, and we can see that on the ends of it, it already has this extra node that we can use to split it apart. So I'm going to select the direct selection tool here, and I'm just going to click on this one node, the one node that I want to remove, and then press delete. And then I'll go here again and make sure that only this one is black. Anything that's black right now is going to be deleted, so we only want this one node to be deleted. And again, I'll press the delete key. And now let's go ahead and select these, and I'm going to start deleting them. And as soon as I delete the first one, you may notice that Photoshop has now actually selected all the nodes on this outside path, so it's actually the path I want to get rid of. So let's just press delete and it will all disappear. And now I have just a single shape. So let's just zoom back out again. And I've got a single shape, so when I brush it, that's how it brushes. So now that we've got these shapes created, we could actually save them if we want to. The first thing I've got to do is actually grab this shape and do edit copy, and then let's just add a new layer here, and then let's do edit paste. And I just want this one shape in this path here. So let's just make sure that's selected, and now I'll choose edit, define custom shape, and we're just going to define this as a custom shape. And now I can delete it. We could go back to this path, grab this shape, delete it entirely since we have it already selected, and this is the shape that we want to this time save. Again, edit, define custom shape, and now we have it as a shape that we can use anytime in future. And we can use this exactly the same way as we would use a regular Photoshop shape. Let's just go and create a new document. Let's go to our shapes. This time our shapes are going to be at the very end here, so here are our lines. And then here is our spiral shape. Now if we want to join lines up together again, let's see how we do that. Let's go into this. I just want to see the ends here. And I want to select the direct selection tool so I can see the nodes that I want to join up. And all we need to do to join them is to go to the pen tool, click on the first one, and then click on the second one. And that will just join them up together. Now sometimes Photoshop may not join them up the way you want, in that we may want a flat end, but we've got our join, we just don't have the end that we want. I'm going to select on these so that I can see where the handles are. This is the handle that I'm interested in, so making sure that I'm using the direct selection tool, I'm going to poise over the top of this handle, which is the one I want to move, and because I only want to move it, I'm going to click and then hold the Alt key as I drag it into position. So I want this to be a straight bar. And then click outside, and you can see that we have exactly what we want. Let's just do this once more. Again, the direct selection tool, because we want to see these nodes, because we want to join them with the pen tool. Click once, and click again. Hasn't exactly been the right shape, but that's not a problem because we're just going to click on it, see what is causing the problem, which is this node here. Hold our mouse pointer over it because we're going to edit it, and press the Alt key as we drag it to make it a straight line. So you can now split shapes and join shapes in Photoshop using these features.